If you have numbness, tingling, pain, weakness, or muscle cramps, your doctor might have ordered a test called electromyography or EMG. If you looked up on the internet, you might be afraid of doing this test because it involves giving electrical shocks to your skin and sticking needles on your muscles. But today, I will explain why we do these tests and what you can expect when your doctor sends you to an EMG test. At the end, I'll also answer some common questions that patients ask me when I tell them that I'm sending them to an EMG with nerve conduction study. So let's talk about EMG today. The nerves are like wires that connect our brain to the rest of the body. The brains receive information from the periphery, we call this sensations, and the brain sends orders to the muscles and bones to move, we call this motor function. The nerves are like roads and highways in a city, carrying information back and forth. In roads with pavement like concrete or asphalt, the speed is much higher than rural roads covered by gravel. There are also single-lane roads or multiple-lane highways. The speed limit can be the same, but the number of cars that travel is much higher with multiple lanes than single-lane roads. We have a similar situation with nerves. This is a nerve. The nerve contains the axons that are the roads carrying information back and forth to the brain. Some axons are covered by myelin. The myelin, it speeds up the electrical transmission. The more myelin around an axon, the higher the speed. It's like having a well-paved road by concrete or asphalt. The nerves that do not have myelin or have a little bit of myelin are similar to rural roads covered by gravel. We also have differences in the amount of information the nerves can carry. It's like roads with more lanes, in other words, more axons, and others that carry fewer information because they don't have many lanes. That is the same for nerves who have fewer axons. When we talk about EMG, we are actually talking about two tests. The nerve conduction study is usually done first, and it will examine the speed of the nerves, and the result will be measured in meters per second. The second part is the EMG test, and it will basically examine how many lanes are open in the road, but not the speed. The nerve conduction study can be done in one arm, both arms, one leg, both legs, or all four limbs. The EMG part can be done in any part of the body that has a muscle, including the face, the tongue, the neck, the lower back, arms, and legs. The nerve conduction study involves electrical shocks to your skin, and the EMG part involves sticking needles in the muscles. First, let me explain the nerve conduction study. In the arm, there are mainly three nerves that can be examined for their speed: the radial nerve, the median nerve, and the ulnar nerve. In the leg, there are mainly three nerves that can be examined: the tibial nerve, the fibular nerve, and the sural nerve. The speed in each nerve can be measured for sensation fibers and for motor fibers. Usually, the speed of the motor fibers is higher than the sensory fibers. That's because the motor fibers have more myelin. And here is how we measure the speed. This device will give an electrical shock to the nerve. Here it is the median nerve above the wrist. And these are surface electrodes that will detect the shock that was discharged by this device. The technician will then measure the distance between the device emitting the electrical shock and the sensor. The machine will tell the time it took for the electrical current to go from point A to point B. Then the technician will calculate the speed in meters per second. Normal speeds are usually around 50 to 60 meters per second. If the calculated speed is lower than expected, then it might be that there is a lesion in the nerve here. The speed of a nerve is determined by the amount of myelin around the nerve. If the myelin is damaged, then the speed in this region will be decreased. The analogy is like an asphalt road that is damaged and the cars can't go fast. There are some diseases that cause a problem of the myelin, for example, multiple sclerosis, MS, and diabetes. Now, let me explain the electromyography part. In order for us to know how many axons are getting to the muscle, or in our analogy, how many lanes of the highway are open, we must ask the muscle to contract, and then we can see and hear the recruitment of the muscle fibers. If all axons are connected to the muscle, or all lanes are opened, then we will see and hear a typical noise that shows a lot of activity in the screen. If we see a few fibers being recruited, then we know that there is some blockage or loss of axons. Some people get scared with the word needle. Here is an EMG needle. Well, in fact, this is not a needle. It's like the one that we give injections. This is a monopolar electrode. You see, it's very thin. This is an injection needle that we use to inject. It's thicker than the EMG needle, but the EMG needle is almost like an acupuncture needle. It's thicker than an acupuncture needle, but it's thin. So the doctor will stick this electrode inside of the muscle and then look at the computer screen and will ask the patient to contract the muscle slightly, then stronger, then very strong. The doctor will also pay attention to the sound that is coming from the muscle, and the higher the sound, it means that there are more axons working or more lanes are opened. There are diseases that affect the axons, like amyotrophic lateral sclerosis or ALS, polymyelitis, diabetes, and alcoholism. I'd like to mention that we can also ask an EMG nerve conduction study to look at the recovery after nerve injury. For example, when a person has an accident that damages a nerve, the muscle innervated by that nerve stops working, and we call this paralysis. The sensations from that body part are also lost, and we call this numbness or anesthesia. When we do EMG, a nerve conduction study of this nerve, we can see if there is nerve regrow and how much longer this is going to take. It's usually very good news to give to the patient that their paralysis and numbness will likely recover. There is a disease called carpal tunnel syndrome that is a pinched nerve here at the level of the wrist. Sometimes we can avoid surgery by doing a nerve conduction study, even without EMG. Because we can demonstrate that the nerve may not be so severely damaged, and then we can postpone or avoid surgery. Some common questions that I get from my patients when I send them to nerve conduction studies, EMGs, are: number one, what to expect when your doctor sends you to an EMG nerve conduction study? First, ask your doctor how many body parts they will examine. One limb, two, three, all four limbs. In general, it takes 30 minutes for each limb. So your doctor asks for maybe all four, two arms, two legs. You may expect 2 hours of exam. And then, first part, the technician will do a nerve conduction study. This involves attaching a lot of electrodes to your skin and then giving the electrical shocks to a distant part of the skin. And the second part is usually done by a medical doctor. They will insert the electrodes in your skin, look at the monitor for the shapes of the waves, and also hear the sounds coming from the muscles. They will ask you to move your muscles while the needle is inside the muscle. Question number two, do I need to prepare for the exam? I usually tell patients not to apply any oil or cream to their skin for a few days before the test. And there is no need to fast or like stop eating or drinking any liquids right before the exam. Number three, is there any contraindication to the test? Yes, people with pacemakers, central lines, defibrillators, and other implanted devices that depend on electrical current should not take part on the nerve conduction studies. And also tell your doctor if you take any blood thinner. That is important to know for the EMG part of the exam. Question number four, is it painful? The nerve conduction part is uncomfortable because of the shocks are like tingling, but not painful. The electromyography can be painful because of the needles. For some people, it can be very painful. For others, they don't bother at all. And the majority of people are right in the middle. If during the exam you find that the pain is too much, you may ask the doctor to modify the technique or stop completely the test. Question number five, can I take some analgesics to feel less pain prior to the test? Yes, you can take your usual painkillers prescribed by your doctors or an over-the-counter acetaminophen or anti-inflammatory. 6. Will the test show if I have a pinched nerve? Yes. When there is a pinched nerve, like a radiculopathy, carpal tunnel syndrome, or ulnar neuropathy, the nerve conduction study and the electromyography may show if the myelin or the axons are damaged. Question number 7. I have tingling and numbness and my nerve conduction study's EMG study is normal. What does this mean? Well, the nerve conduction study's EMG is only capable to examining large nerve fibers. And there are very tiny fibers that cannot be examined by nerve conduction study's EMG. This is called small fiber neuropathy. And the best way to examine these fibers are by doing a sensory exam using cotton ball, a sharp object on the skin. Please don't forget that this video is for educational purposes only. If you have a condition that needs medical advice, please talk to your doctor. And if there is an emergency, go to the nearest emergency department. Press the share button below to send this video to anyone that needs to learn about nerve conduction studies or electromyography. In the comments below, write down if you had an EMG and what did you think of it and what did you do to alleviate your pain during the exam. If you like this video, give a thumbs up here, turn on the notifications, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. You can also find me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Thank you for watching. Bye!